यदा ही इंद्रियार्थेषु न कर्मसु अनुसज्जते सर्व संकल्प सन्यासी जुगारूढ सदस्यते ऊर्धरेतात्मनात्मानम् नात्मानम् अवसादयत् आत्मैव अर्थात्मनो बंधुर आत्मैव रिपुरात्मनम् नाउ दीज टू श्लोकास वर्सेस वी आर डिस्कसिंग लास्ट डे दैट वी हैव टू रेज आवर सेल्फ टू द स्पिरिचुअल स्टैंडर्ड बाय अर्थ I have to raise myself to the spiritual standard by myself. So I am my friend and I am my enemy. This is the opportunity. There is a very nice verse in Chanakya Pandit. Nakaschit kasyachit mitram, nakaschit kasyachit ripu. व्यवहार न जायते मित्राणी व्यवस्था नोबडी इज फ्रेंड नोबडी इज नोबडी इज एनिमी बट इट इज ओनली द बिहेवियर बाय व्हिच वन कैन अंडरस्टैंड हु इज हिज फ्रेंड एंड हु इज हिज एनिमी नोबडी इज बॉर्न एनिमी Nobody is born friend. But by our mutual behavior, somebody is my friend and somebody is my enemy. Similarly, as we have this dealing in the ordinary daily affairs, similarly, I have my dealing with myself. But if I deal with me, myself, as friend, then I am my friend, and if I deal with myself enemically, then what is that friendship and enemical? The friendship is that I am sold somehow or other, I have been in contact with this material nature. So I have to get myself out of the entanglement of this material nature. If I act in that way, then I am my friend. But even after getting this opportunity, if I do not act in that way, then I am my enemy. So, ātmaiva jhātmano bandhu, rātmaiva jhātmano ripu. So I am myself friend, my friend, and I am my enemy. बंधुरात्मा आत्मनस्त जीन आत्मना जित अनात्मनस्त शत्रुते वर्तता आत्म शत्रुव हाउ आई कैन बी बिकम माई फ्रेंड दैट इज एक्सप्लेन हियर दैट बंधुरात्मा आत्मनस्त आत्मा मीन्स माइंड आत्मा मीन्स बॉडी एंड आत्मा मीन्स सोल That these three things I have already explained the other day. That when you speak of Atma or Self, just like so long I have got my bodily conception. When I say myself, I think of my body. When I transcend the bodily conception of life, then I think I am mine. But actually, when I am in this real spiritual platform, then myself means I am pure spirit. So according to the state of development, my conception of self are different. so far Nirukta or dictionary is concerned, body, mind and the spirit, soul, everything is called self. Now here it is called बंधुर आत्मा आत्मनस्तस्य नाउ हियर वन आत्मा इज मेंट माइंड माइंड इज द फ्रेंड ऑफ वन सेल्फ एंड माइंड इज द एनिमी ऑफ वन सो यू हैव टू ट्रेन द माइंड इफ आई ट्रेन माई माइंड फॉर बिकमिंग माई फ्रेंड then my life is successful. If I train my mind to become my enemy, then my life is unsuccessful. Anatmanastu satrute bhakti kaha atmaiva satruva. But one who has no knowledge of the spiritual self, then his mind acts like his enemy. One who has got the conception of this body as myself, his mind is his enemy. And one who has got the conception of the spirit self, his mind is his friend. So mind has nothing to do. Mind simply training of the mind requires. And how the mind is trained? It is by good association. Good association, our mind is trained. Sangha sanjayate kama. Kama means desire. Desire is the function of the mind. And sangha sanjayate kama. And according to the association, my mind desires like that. So we have to make good association. If we want to make our mind as my friend, if I want to make my friend as my mind as my friend, then I have to associate with sadhu. Tasmat sasu sadjeta buddhiman. Buddhiman means intelligent person. He must associate with satsu. Satsu means those who are trying for self-realization. They are called sat. Sat and asat. Asat means those who are trying for the temporary things. Matter is temporary. My body is temporary. So if I simply engage myself for bodily pleasure, sense gratification, then I am engaging myself to temporary things. But if I engage myself for self-realization, the permanent thing, then I am engaging myself to the sat or to the permanent. So tasma satsu sajjeta buddhiman, anyone who is intelligent, he should associate with persons who are trying to elevate themselves for self-realization. That is called satsang, good association. And what is the result of good association? Now, because if we make good association, the santa chindanti, santa means the persons who are sadhu, who are pious, they can cut off by their words our attachment to this material world. They can cut off, just like Krishna is speaking to Arjuna. What is the idea of speaking so many things? Just to cut off his attachment from the so-called material affection. He is affected with something which is stumbling his progress in his own duty. So Krishna is presenting his Bhagavad Gita just to cut off. Santa eva hi chindanti ukti bhi. They chindanti means cut. Now, for cutting something, we require some sharpened instrument. But here, to cut off the mind from attachment, it requires sharpened ukti. Ukti means word. Sharpened topic. There should not be. Just like when a person cuts something, there is no mercy. Similarly, when a sadhu or a person speaks to his friend, to his student, he does not make so any mercy. He speaks the truth so that his mind may be cut off from the undual attachment. Just like Krishna is saying. Krishna, Arjuna, first address to Arjuna. He says, asachyanamisuchastam prajñāvādāṁsavāsas. You are talking like a very learned man, but you are fool number one. You see, how strong word he has used. So far, if we want detachment from this material world, then we should be prepared to accept such cutting words from the Master. Sanda asya chindanti uktivi. We should not make compromise. So don't speak such strong words. It is required. So bandhunat anatmana stu satrute bhateta atvaiva satru. Anatma. Those who have no self-realization, his mind, one who has not realized is what he is. We are generally conception of this bodily conception of our life. But the intelligent person who has made association with saintly persons, he can understand that I am not this body. And the material conception of life is condemned in so many places. Jasnātma buddhi kunapi tridhātaki sadhikkalatrādiṣu bhomai jadhi jatīrtha buddhi sarile. In so many ways, the one who has got the conception of his personal self with this body made of three elements, one who thinks that the land in which he is born or the relatives who is connected with this body, they are all everything. Then that man is no better than ass and cow, it is said like that. So we should have, by good association, by study of good books like Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavatam, we should realize ourselves. Otherwise, our mind will remain always an enemy. And enemy, as the enemy is always prepared to do harm, so my mind will drag me to things which will make me entangled more and more in this material, miserable life. Manasasthani indriyani prakitisthani karsati. We are struggling very hard with this mind and sixth sense. So we have to make the mind our friend. Now Krishna is gradually making progress to explain to Arjuna how the mind can be made fresh. Jītātmana prasāntasya paramātmā samāhitaḥ śītoṣṇa sukha-dukkheṣu tathāmānā pumānaya jñāna-vijñāna-cittyātmā kṛtastha viditendriya yuktā yuktuccate yogī samalusrāśma-kāñcana. Now, by training the mind, jītātmana, one who has conquered by the mind, jītātmana, prasāntasya. Prasant means he has become in equilibrium, prasant. Prasant, because mind is dragging me always in non-permanent thing. Harāva bhaktasya kuto mahadguna manorathena asato bhāvat vahi asato manorathena. By the chariot of the mind, so long we are seated on the chariot of the untrained mind, unbridled mind, the mind will drag me to things which are non-permanent. But my whole business is that I am permanent, I am eternal. Somehow or other, I have got this attachment for non-permanent things, so I have to get out of this entanglement. So if my mind is not trained up, then the mind's business will be to drag me to non-permanent things. Harāva bhaktasya kuto mahadguna. But this mind, as I told you the other day, can be very easily trained up if we fix up in our mind, on the fort of the mind, the great soldier, Krishna. Just like if the fort is defended by a great general, then there is no question of entering of the enemies. Similarly, if we put Krishna on the fort of the mind, then there is no chance of entering of the enemies. Savai mana Krishna padaravinde, that day we have explained. And if we do not do that, harāva bhaktasya kuto mahadguna. Mahadguna means the material acquisition, material education, material wealth, or so many material qualifications, that will not help me to control my mind. That is not possible. Only thing is that if I put on the mind Krishna, God, Harabhakti, Krishna consciousness, then my mind will be very easily calm. Jitātmanā prasāntasya. Prasānta means who has ceased to desire material enjoyment. Bhavantameva charan nirantaram prasānta nishesa manorathantaram. A devotee is praying to the Lord. Bhavantameva charan nirantaram. When I shall be able to act 24 hours in your service, or when I shall be able to think of you 10%, and prasanta nishesa manorathantaram. Manorathantaram means mind is dragging me in so many imaginations, so many plan-making business. We have got so many plan-making business. That is called manorathantaram. Just like I go on some chariot, on some car, in several places, the mind is, the same thing is described, maya jantra ruhena maya. So we are traveling like that way. But as soon as I am able to fix my mind on the lotus feet of Krishna, in Krishna consciousness, it becomes jitātmana. Jitātmana means conquered. And then my mind becomes clear of all these engagement of non-permanent thing, prasāntasya. Jītātmana prasāntasya paramātmā samāhitaḥ. That is possible. Paramātmā means super soul. We have several times told you that paramātmā is with me. The same thing. Paramātmā is sitting with me in the heart. I, the soul, the atomic part, spirit part, that is also in the heart. And side by side, in the similar, smallest way, the Supreme Lord is also with me. Paramātmā samāhita. This Paramātmā samāhita is the yoga. Now, Krishna will gradually come, Paramātmā. The yoga system is, meditation means to control all the senses and concentrate the mind to focus on the Paramātmā. That is the whole yoga system. So here it is hinted, Paramātmā samāhita, completely absorbed in the Paramātmā. Prasānta. Prasānta means cease from all non-permanent activity. And jītātmana. Jītātmana means conquered by the center. So jītātmana prasāntasya paramātmā samāhita sītoshna sukadukheshu tathāmāna apamāna. Sītoshna sukadukheshu. Duality. Duality. We have got in this material world duality. Just like this is now summer season. And then again we'll have winter season, snowfall. Sita usna. Sita means winter season, and Ushna means summer season. Sitoshna, sukha-dukha-su. Similarly, happiness and distress. Happiness and distress. Tatha mana-pumana. Similarly, honor and dishonor. Because in this world of duality, dual world, everything is to be understood by duality. We cannot understand what is honor if there is no dishonor. If I am not insulted, I cannot understand what is honor. So, mana-pamana, similarly, I cannot understand what is misery if I am not tasted happiness. Or I cannot understand what is happiness if I am not understood misery. So similarly, I cannot understand what is cold if I have not tasted hot. This world is a duality. So one has to transcend. So long this body is there, this duality feeling will continue. So, because I am trying to get out of this body, bodily conception, not exactly out of the body, but bodily conception, so I'll have to practice to tolerate this duality. As in the second chapter, Krishna has advised Arjuna, Matras prasastu kunti asitosna sukhavastava. This duality of distress and happiness, this is due to the skin. This is skin disease. Just like itching of the skin. So, because there is itching, I should not be mad after it. I should tolerate. There are so many that nowadays mosquito bite is going on. So, we should not be mad. We should not give up our duty because mosquito is biting or some big bug is biting. So many dualities we have to tolerate. So, if my mind is always in Krishna consciousness, then these dualities can be practiced very easily. Sitosna sukhada kada. Jnana-vijnana trityatma kutastha vijitendriya. Why he will be able to understand, to tolerate? Because jnana-vijnana-trityatma. Jnana means knowledge. Theoretical knowledge is called jnana. And practical knowledge is called vijnana. Just like a science student has to study theoretical and appear theoretical examination as well as practical examination. If a science student has to pass his examination, then he has to practice simply theoretical knowledge that so much quantity of hydrogen and so much quantity of oxygen will make water, will not help him. He has to practically show in the laboratory that so much quantity of oxygen gas and so much quantity of hydrogen gas mixed and water is produced. That is called vijnana. Jnana-vijnana-vitisthana. One should have not only theoretical knowledge, but practical knowledge. Practical knowledge. Simply understanding that I am not this body, I am not this body, then I am doing all nonsense of this body. I am discussing. And there are so many societies. They are very seriously discussing Vedanta philosophy smoking with wine glass and very enjoying life, you see. But that sort of jnana, that sort of knowledge is not necessary, you see. So, jnana-vijnana. One should have knowledge perfectly and it must be demonstrated. Demonstrated in practical sense. Yes. That means one who has actually felt himself that I am not this body. Then naturally his bodily necessities will be reduced to the minimum. Will be reduced to the minimum. That is practical. If I am going to increase the demands of my body and I am simply theoretical thing that I am not this body, that is not required. Jnana-vijnana-pratisthapanam and man, a person will be satisfied when there is jnana, knowledge and science side by side. Jnana, vijnana, practical. Kutastha, vijita, indriya. Then he conquered for the senses. Jnana, vijnana, vijita, tatrastha, vijita, indriya. Jukta, ituchyate, yogi, samalustrasma, kanchana. So, when he is situated in that practical status, of spiritual realization, then he is to be understood that he is actually situated in the yoga. Not that I am going to a class and weekly or twice weekly attending yoga class and I remain the same thing for the so many years. No, there should be practical realization. What is that practical realization? Prasanta Atma. Prasanta Atma, the mind is calm and quiet. no more agitated by the attraction of this material entanglement. So, jnana vijnatam kutasva viditam. And this is the first qualification, this qualification is self-control. Advancement in the yoga system means yoga indriya samyama. Yoga means to, because our whole life is disturbed due to the senses. And this material life is sense-getting. The common substance of materialistic life means sense-getting. Therefore, advancement of material science means giving you products for your sense gratification. Unnecessarily, so many things are produced just to satisfy my senses. That is material advancement. So material life means sense gratification and spiritual life means detached from sense gratification. So visiting in this. Jitta ituchati yogi samalo sasma kanchan. And when he is in that position, equilibrium, then for him, sama lostrasma kanchana, kanchana means gold, and lostra means, rebels of stone, they are the same thing. So, sama lostrasma kanchana. And again, suhin mitra durasinam madhyastha desa bandhusu sadhusapi cha papesu samabuddhi visishyat. We have got our relationship in this world. We call that he is my friend. Sweet and mitra. There are two kinds of friends. Sweet means better friend. Actually, who is always desiring my welfare. He is called sweet. And friend means, we have got goodwill, ordinary friend. Sweet mitra, udasina. Udasina means neutral, neither friend nor enemy. We have got relationship within this world. Somebody is my very good well-wisher, somebody is my friend, and somebody is neither friend nor enemy. And somebody madhyastha, mediator, and somebody doing some good. Somebody I think, here is a nice gentleman, saintly person. And somebody I think, here is a sinful man. According to my calculation, somebody my friend, somebody my enemy, somebody neutral, somebody, saintly person, somebody, sinful person. Now all these, when you are on the yoga-yukta, when you are in the platform of transcendence, then these distinctions, this friend, enemy, sadhu, saintly, and sinful, that is all closed. No. Pandita samadarsha. Pandita, when one becomes actually learned, he does not see any enemy or any friend. Because nobody is enemy, nobody is friend. Nobody is my son, nobody is my mother, nobody is... We are all different living entities. We are just playing on the platform under the grace of father, mother, wife, children, friend, enemy, just like in a drama. We set up some character to play. But out of the stage, we are all friends. Nobody. In the stage, I say, you are enemy, I shall kill you, and so many things I do. But when out of the stage, we are all friends. Similarly, in this world, in this material world, with this dress of material body, we are playing on the stage of material world, that enemy and friend and father, mother, son. I cannot beget any son. It is not possible. I simply beget this body. You see? The living entity, that is not my power. simply by my sex intercourse with my wife, I cannot produce unless that living entity is placed in that emancipation of true Sri Krishna. These are stated in the Srimad Bhagavatam. So this is only stage play. So actually, when one is situated in proper knowledge, one who is actually a yogi, for him, this distinction altogether disappears. Yogi jinjita satata atmanam rahasisthita. Now here is the beginning of the yoga system, how one should perform yoga. Now you will understand from the description of Bhagavad Gita that what is yoga system. In your city, New York City, yoga is very popular. Everyone is performing yoga. There are so many groups of yoga schools. But just see what the yoga system is, you can understand from Bhagavad Gita. What is that? The first is, yogi junjita satatam atmanam rahasisthita. The yogi's business is always to remain alone in a secluded place. Alone and secluded place. Yoga cannot be performed in assembly, just like we are in assembly. You are performing yoga, I am performing yoga in the yoga class, and somebody is teaching, do like this, do like that, do like that. That is not yoga. At least according to Bhagavad Gita. Here it is clearly said that yogi junjita satatam atmanam rahasikrita. He should always be engaged in focusing his mind towards the Paramatma, and that is possible. Rahasi. Rahasi means in a secluded place. It is not, I cannot concentrate my mind in the hubble bubble of the society or in the big city. The yoga system is fine. All the yogis formally. Still, in India, there are many yogis. They come at Kumbh Mela. We have seen some of them. Some of them are 700 years old. And you'll see him just like a boy of 25 years. They are doing some yoga. So that really they come when there is some special function. In India, there are four places, just like in modern days, there are conferences of different parties. Similarly, in India, there are still about 30,000 of saintly persons, not one, two. And they, not all, but at least major portion of them, they meet together after 12 years and in some particular place. There are four places. One at Prayag. You have heard the name of Allahabad city. That is called Prayag. And one at Haridwar and at Kankhar. In this way, there are about four places. That means every 4 years they are meeting. So in that meeting, many yogis come. When not in my this renounced order, when I was living for some time at Allahabad, not some time, I lived there for 13 years at Allahabad. So I was seeing this mela. Although it was taking every 12 years, I have seen twice or thrice. These yogis, they are so calm and quiet. And looking, of course I do not know, somebody says this man is 700 years old, this man is 300 years old, but they look like young boys. So these such yogis, as it is recommended here, yogi jundita satatam atmanam have. One who is actually ascended on the yogic principle, his first function is that he remains alone. He has no society. He cannot remain in society. Yogi jindita sattvam rahasi sthita ekaki. Ekaki means alone. It's more clearly it is said, ekaki. Jata chittatma nirasi ra paribdha. Nirasi, there is no expectation that by functioning yoga I shall achieve this power, and aparibdha, and he does not take anything from anybody. Who is going to give you? He is at ekaki, he is alone, in a secluded place, in sometimes in jungle, in forest, in mountain, and who is going to give him anything? He doesn't expect, because he is, his father convinced that, for whom I have become yogi, I am not alone. My Paramatma is always with me. What kind of yogi? Although he remains superficially alone, but he knows that wherever I go, my Paramatma friend, who is sitting with me on my heart, he is with me. So I am nothing to fear. Jata chitna atma, ekaki, jata chitna atma nirashi ra parigraha. He does not accept anything. Finally. Now just see the yogi principle. For this age, how much it is difficult for us. If we want to perform real yoga system, then it is very difficult. We are sitting here, so many ladies and gentlemen, is it possible for us to live alone in a secluded place in a mountain? You have got in the outside your New York City, there are so many mountains and jungles. Can you live there alone? Oh, no. At the present moment, the modern way of our civilization and mode of our life, I am a sannyasi. I am renounced at the order of life, but still I have come to a city, New York City, the largest city of the world. From Bombay city or Calcutta city I have come. So life has become so changed that in this age, actually what is called yoga, it is not possible. It's not. First condition is that ekaki jata chittatma. He should remain alone. He should perform yoga system alone, not in with friends and many other yogis. No. Jagatitnapa nirasi aparigraha, and he should have no desire in his mind, and aparigraha, he does not want anything from anybody. This is the first condition. The next condition, sucho deshe pratishthapa siram asanam atmanaha. Nastu chitang nasu nijan chila jino kusottaram. This yogi has to fix up his sitting place. What is that? Sucho desi. He should select a place which is very, very pure. Now that means a place like Haridwar, our young friend, Mr. Howard, he has been to Haridwar, he has seen how nicely that place is. River Ganges is flowing, and very nice, calm and quiet. He'll find 3 miles after, 4 miles after, one yogi is sitting nicely there and meditating. That is yogi. Sucho there, in a place where they sanctified them. So these places are especially selected, just like Haridwar, Kankhar, and Prayag. They are from time immemorial, and in Vedic age, those places are sanctified. Just like this Bhagavad Gita was spoken in the battlefield of Kurukshetra, Dharmakshetra, the land of religiousness. In war was performed, because this war was not ordinary war. that was religious one. Religious one. His Kurukshetra battle, that was religious one. Don't you find in the war field where Sri Krishna, the Supreme Personality of God, is present? Do you think it is ordinary war? No. It is not ordinary war. No. And it was performed in a place which is called in terms of religiosity. That is prescribed, that is required. So, yes, Suchaudesh, perfectly sanctified place. Suchaudesh is Pratishthapa. He must be situated in a very sanctified place. Thiram Asanam Atmana. And the asanam and the sitting place should not be changed. The same asana. He should perform yoga, meditation, on the same place and the same sitting place. Atmana. How that place, the sitting place should be selected? Na uti uchitam. Not too much raised, not too much low, not niche. And chila jina kusatram. Chila means cotton something, cotton sitting place. Then skin, deer skin means, you know, yogis, they sit on the skin of tiger and skin of deer. Why? Because they are in a secluded place, this has got some chemical effect. If you sit on tiger skin and deer skin, then the reptiles, the snakes, they won't disturb. It has got some, physical effect. There are so many medical effects in so many things we do not know. But God has created everything for our use. We do not know that every plant, every herb is a medicine. It is meant for some particular disease, for some particular protection. We do not know that. So chirajina, it is not a fashion. It is because they sit down in a secluded place in a jungle, so you are meditating, so some snake may come. There are so many snakes, so many reptiles. So therefore, chila, jina, kusottaram, and straw. The three things. Straw, and the skin, and some cotton, hasan. These things are required. Then, what is the next process? The next process is tatraika agamana kritta jata chittindriya kriya upavishya asane junyat yoga atma visiddhaye. Atma visiddhaya, the whole process is, yoga system is for purifying Atma. Purifying Atma, you always remember, the Atma means this body, Atma means the mind, Atma means the soul. So purifying, these things. The yoga system is means not that cheaply I want some power. Sometimes the yogis achieve very wonderful power. Astasiddhi yoga. Astasiddhi, any kinds of perfection, material perfection they can attain. Not for that purpose, yogas, although they attain that power. Real yogis, they do not exhibit. They do not exhibit. He has got the power, so many wonderful powers, but he does. His only aim is Atma Visuddhaya. I am now contaminated by this material atmosphere, so I have to purify myself. So that purification process we shall discuss next day. But I may say in this connection that so much difficult process for purifying the Atma is very easily done. Cetadarpanamarjanam by chanting this Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram. Because the sound, this transcendental sound vibration is non-different from Krishna. Krishna is absolute. His name is not different from him. So when you chant his name with devotion, that means Krishna is with you. And Krishna, when Krishna is with you, how you can remain impure? You become pure, the pure. That is the whole system. Now,